Jesus says, be quiet. Some translations say that he spoke sternly, be quiet. The devil wanted us to believe that Jesus came to destroy or to silence demons. Jesus tells us he came to teach, to empower us to be his disciples. This is one of Satan's temptations, attempting to divert Jesus from his mission of preparing for disciples. Satan wanted Jesus to be content with just casting out demons and healing people. That's what the devil wanted. The devil did not win in the wilderness, so he tried to overwhelm Jesus with healing people and casting out demons. Notice Desire of Ages, page 260. In the excitement which he then pervaded Capernaum, there was danger that the object of his mission would be lost sight of. Jesus was not satisfied to attract attention to himself merely as a wonder worker or a healer of physical diseases. He was seeking to draw men to him as their Savior. Now, Jesus healed a lot of people, but that was not his primary mission. That was not his primary purpose. It was to save mankind, and it was to prepare people to go and proclaim the gospel. Now, the first case of healing we find in verse 29. And immediately after they had come out of the synagogue, they came into the house of Simon and Andrew and James and John. Now, Simon's mother-in-law was lying sick with a fever, and immediately they spoke to him about her. And he came to her and raised her up, taking her by the hand, and the fever left her, and she waited on them. And when the evening had come, after the sun had set, they began bringing to him all who were ill, those who were demon-possessed. And the whole city gathered at the door. He healed many who were ill with various diseases, cast out many demons. He was not permitting the demons to speak because they knew who he was. Now, Peter's mother-in-law was not trying to distract from Jesus' teaching. But Jesus was committed to the act of compassion. And all day, all night, late into the hours, he was healing people and he was casting out demons. It says the whole city came. And then early in the morning, he was in prayer. And he could have said, man, it was a long day. I think I'll take the night off. But as was his custom, he was in prayer, seeking the Father, seeking wisdom and strength. He was freeing people from demon possession, from diseases. That wasn't why he came. It wasn't the primary reason he came. But Jesus models for us that we are to be compassionate. Verse 35, early in the morning, when it was still dark, he rose and went and departed to a lonely place and was there doing what?
Praying.
He was praying. Is that good counsel for us? Jesus goes off alone early in the morning to pray. He had not followed Satan's counsel. Satan says, throw yourself off the top of this building, and the people will be impressed. But now Satan found an opportunity. The crowds are coming. They have real needs. And Jesus meets those needs. And Satan is trying to convince Jesus to perform for the applause of the crowd. But that's not who he was. He was not called here to this earth to cast out demons. He was called to save humanity. He was called to prepare a people to finish the work. He was not here for political power. He was not here for human adoration, but he was compassionate. He was mindful of the needs of people. Now the disciples had a different perception. They saw all these people coming, and they saw all these people being healed and demons being cast out, and they said, man, look at the crowds. We're on the right track. Then they looked around and Jesus was not there. In verse 36, Simon and his companions hunted for him. Verse 37, and they found him and said to him, everyone's looking for you. I believe that Peter is reprimanding Jesus. He's criticizing Jesus. He's saying, what are you doing here? Could you imagine telling Jesus he's wrong? That's what Peter was doing. He says, you need to be down there healing more people. This is what it's about. We need to draw more crowds. Verse 38, and he said to them, let us go somewhere else to towns nearby in order that I may preach there also, for that is what I came to do. You know, he says, that's why I've come. He tells Peter, this is who I am. This is my purpose. I come to preach the gospel and to prepare you for ministry. Now, he doesn't tell Peter that he's coming to die. Although Peter should have known that when John said he is the Lamb of God. And the Lamb was to be sacrificed. Jesus' ministry is not the short-term alleviation of pain. Instead, he is called to preach, to teach his disciples, to live out the gospel. Verse 39, and he went to their synagogues throughout all Galilee, preaching and casting out demons. As he did not want those demons, making the proclamation of who he was. Jesus resisted the temptation of following the crowds. Jesus' focus was to heal the spirit of man, not just the physical part. Healing of bitterness and hostility, of lust and anger, of worry and anxiety, and healing people of their critical spirits. He came to deliver us from these things, not just physical illnesses. The healing of the spirit is permanent. Jesus had a clear vision of what his mission and his purpose was. To be the Lamb of God. To save humanity. And to prepare people to spread the good news. The devil wanted him to become the king of Israel without going through the cross. To draw men to him through showmanship instead of sacrifice. To have a short-term mission rather than a long-term. He wanted Jesus to fight demons and conquer death instead of dealing with people's spiritual needs. There's always the temptation to follow the urgent rather than the important. There's a picture. It's called Tyranny of Urgency. And a man is standing and he's stamping on ants and he's killing them. But you can see a window. And through that window is coming a herd of elephants. He's more concerned about the ants than he is about those elephants. And that's what the devil wants. He wants us to stamp out the ants, to be caught up in the little things of life, rather to be aware of the important things. In our ministry, that we are disciples of Jesus Christ, and he has given us a gospel message to preach, to tell people that the kingdom of God is near. Satan is looking for ways to distract us. Just as he looked to distract Jesus, he is looking to distract us. He's looking for us to say, well, you know, That's what we pay the pastor for, let him do that. Or that's what the elders are for. Or that's what community service is for, let them do that. Do not disturb me. I'm standing on this. We need to be compassionate. We need to model compassion. We need to help people realize that there's hope through Jesus Christ. And no matter how bad their situation is, there is hope. There's reason to believe and reason to keep on with life. The devil will do everything he can to make your life look hopeless. But remember, when we're in Jesus Christ, he's given us a mission. That's why I said, go home. Have your lunch. Have your Sabbath activities. And spend time in prayer with God and say, Lord, what is your mission for me? Expand my mind. Stretch me beyond my comfort zone. What is it you want me to do? Every Christian has a mission. We should not try to be somebody else's mission, but to use the spiritual gifts that God has given to us. And he has empowered us with. And to keep preaching that message, the kingdom of God is near. And if you have to use words, use the word of God. But keep preaching. Let's pray. Father in heaven, I thank you for Mark and for the message he gives to us, for showing us the mission of Jesus of not only saving the world, but preparing us to be fishers of men. Lord, help us not to be distracted. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen.